They thought they looked so cold in this picture. They thought they looked so cold in this picture, like they were the next group. Yeah, take a pic. Yeah, this is gonna go crazy on Facebook. Yeah, take a pic. Take a picture. Yeah. We the next Justice League. Take a picture. Phoenix Jones. Oh my gosh.
If you've ever done research into the topic of real-life superheroes in the past, there's a high likelihood that you've stumbled across the story of Benjamin Fodor, known primarily
check
by
his Facebook right now. This video dropped 4 months ago. Ain't none.
Alter ego, Phoenix Jones. For a brief time, he was revered as a beacon of hope within the confines of his own city, only to eventually ruin his reputation and become a prime example of how fame and influence can corrupt morals and cloud judgment. But before we can truly understand how Phoenix became such a polarizing figure, we must look at his background and origin. Benjamin was born on May 25th, 1988, and had a rough upbringing. He would go on to become an amateur fighter, studying mixed martial arts, and actually managed to gain somewhat of a name for himself within the community alongside his adoptive brother, Carlos Fodor. As he became older, his passion for assisting those in need became stronger, leading him to become a teacher for autistic students. But it wouldn't be long until his desire to help his fellow citizens grew into a desire for something greater. Something larger than life, if you will. Phoenix first began rising to prominence as a superhero thanks to his association with a larger group of like-minded individuals called the Rain City Superhero Movement, operating in the city of Seattle.
Nah, bro, these superhero groups are actually killing me, bro. Yeah, this can't be a real video or a real picture. No. No, please. They actually got superhero groups in their cities. What am I doing with my life? Why don't I create my own superhero group in my city? Damn!
In Washington, all 8 of the members had their own unique personas and identities, all wanting to aid law enforcement in any way they could and potentially even prevent crime.
The Capitol Rock and the Black, that's not
Jones
me, bro.
Jones himself stated in a 2010 interview with the Daily Beast that one of the main motivators for him starting his crime-fighting career was an incident involving his car being broken into. After going to investigate his broken window, his young son allegedly cut himself on accident. After this incident, his father decided he would try to do something to curb the rampant crime occurring in his city.
Even makes
from
sense.
The very beginning,
I mean, it doesn't make sense that he become a superhero, but it makes sense.
A great deal of hesitancy towards their mission, believing that the group may become more of a liability and hindrance than anything else.
Police are perplexed, worried the group will turn into vigilantes, and skeptical that they've ever actually stopped any crime.
Our concern is if it goes badly.
Grown men running around in costumes. Man, that's my dream. Man, that's my dream.
We end up getting called anyway, and we may have additional victims.
To be clear, Phoenix had been engaging in the superhero business for a while at this point, but had largely gone unnoticed with very little press coverage.
Why? Superheroes usually wear a mask to hide their identity. So why exactly do you wear a mask and then take it off when the press is there? L fake superheroes.
Once news outlets began to dig deeper into this story, they realized the potential and began to scrutinize the self-proclaimed crime fighter closer. His suit looked like something straight out of a movie, featuring a bulletproof vest as well as various other heavy-duty equipment, all designed to prevent himself from getting serious.
Who made
injured.
Did his wife make that, or did he make that?
At this time, but had not yet revealed it to the public, possibly in an effort to prevent Jones from becoming a target for criminals and putting
him in harm's
way.
Oh, okay, so the mask was actually working.
Or perhaps they didn't want to encourage his activity. The strangeness of his actions, as well as his willingness to talk to the press, soon made him a rising star, with his escapades being documented by the mainstream news outlets. In January of 2011, it was reported that Jones had stopped a carjacking, intervening and chasing off the would-be thieves before police had a chance to arrive.
And you just start sticking it down inside between the window here and the rubber strip.
Dan was calling 911, but help flew in before he finished dialing.
From the right, this guy comes dashing in, just wearing this skin-tight rubber black and gold suit. And
oh man, life is a comedy.
This was a clear turning point, as he'd actually proven that he could do good work that benefited those around him. Positive press such as this would continue to
So how do these guys make money? Like, if they don't have jobs and stuff, how do they make money? That's why I don't understand that.
Common theme with Phoenix Jones. And he
cool name though, Phoenix Jones.
Base of folks who liked and respected him for actually taking a step and, you know, doing some good in his community, doing what he thought was right. Reports such as this all boosted his reputation, with Jones becoming a sensation, and he was often recognized by people on the street who were familiar with his antics. However, there were numerous concerns from critics as well. While most of them acknowledged that they appreciated the sentiment behind what he was doing, many believe that intervening in dangerous situations should be left up to law enforcement and not private citizens. Many of his adventures were also caught on camera due to the involvement of self-proclaimed filmmaker Ryan McNamee, who documented many of the real-life superhero escapades, uploading many of these.
We'll have to watch some of these another day.
To this day, numerous of these videos remain on YouTube, providing some interesting insight into the early days of Phoenix Jones. However, not everyone approved of his methods. While it's to be expected that there's going to be a fair amount of skeptics in the press, he was extremely controversial even within the community that he was a part of. An article published by the Wall Street Journal in February of 2012 revealed that other heroes such as Night Owl and Zeta Man disapproved of Phoenix's tendency to involve himself in dangerous situations.
So there's a multiverse of other superheroes that disagree with what he's doing.
Situations. They were part of a completely different organization called the Real Life Superhero Group, being one of the rival superhero's top critics throughout his rapid rise.
What are we doing, bruh? What are we genuinely doing, bruh? He has rival superheroes. What?
To fame, with Night Owl himself stating, quote, "Whether intentionally or not, he's representing the superhero community now, and that makes some people nervous." The two groups reportedly attempted to bridge the divide by patrolling together, but this only ended with relations between them becoming worse, with Night Owl's superhero group completely distancing themselves from the Rain City superhero movement. All in all, it was clear that they were unimpressed by the Rising Star's philosophy, believing him to be a bad
representative. Yo, you know, this actually reminds me. A lot of, like, old heads say how weird this generation is, and they're right. It is really weird. Our generation is really weird. You're right. A lot of people dressing up as animals and all these things. I'm not going to get too deep into it. But you're telling me the older generation was dressing up like literal superheroes and patrolling the city and fighting crime, and they're not weird? Yeah, bruh. I'm convinced now that we only have social media, and it's a lot more prominent, which is why we're able to see all the weird stuff we have now. But back then, they did just as weird things. They just didn't have the publicity for it. That's what I'm convinced. This is what the video is telling me, bro. Like, this is the only explanation.
Representative, like, what?
I thought it was only one person, two, three, four, five people. Like, you feel me? There's teams. There are teams.
Was more centered around charitable action as opposed to physically mimicking their fictional counterparts and, you know, like, intervening on crimes in a vigilante type way. Towards the end of 2011, it would seem that the suspicions of his critics would be proven correct after a particularly controversial incident took place. As the story goes, a group of individuals were dancing in the street in the early hours of the morning and were shocked after a masked individual approached and began pepper spraying them for seemingly no reason. This obviously angered them a great deal, with the situation rapidly escalating.
Phoenix Jones, the city's most prolific superhero, complete with a full body costume, running to help others. Jones says he thought it was a fight and tried to break it up. The whole scene is being...
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. What was that one superhero movie? Incredibles. Where, like, the Incredibles, like, did something that made them seem bad to the public. And then they were getting hunted now. And their superhero thing was getting shut down. This idiot just did the same thing, basically. On camera, 4K, he just pepper sprayed some random civilians, and now he has a bad look to the public. Oh, brother, you cooked yourself.
Ryan McNamee, a documentary videographer.
Let's see, he did use spray, but only when things were out of control.
McNamee says the crowd Jones thought he was helping turned on him.
Watch out.
And it's Jones's use of pepper spray that police say led to his arrest for assault.
I mean, that's illegal.
The mysterious man who approached them was none other than Phoenix Jones.
See, look, it was cool. Now he looked corny.
He faced a significant amount of backlash for his actions here. He would go on to defend himself by claiming the individuals involved had actually been fighting, and he only had been trying to break them up. However, Jones's account of events completely contradicted what the victims had to say. Police also took this opportunity to reaffirm their initial fears about Jones and his style.
In the police report about the incident, the officer wrote that Jones has had a history of injecting himself in these incidents. Recently, there have been increased reports of citizens being pepper sprayed by Jones and his group, adding that Jones has been advised to observe and report incidents to 911. He continues to try to resolve things on his own.
While he had called 911 after the alleged fight had been broken up, many still believe that it was irresponsible for him to insert
it
himself
was, bro.
In a dangerous situation.
It was.
Especially using...
Yeah, don't do this. Yo, don't do this where I'm from, bro. You get shot, deadass. I'm sorry, bro. Don't try doing that where you'll get shot. I'm not trying to say I'm from the hood or... Don't do it where I'm from. You're going to get shot 1,000%. Facts. Shot or stabbed. It's a fact. Do not try that anywhere where I'm from.
Any sort of weapon.
You go get your
ass. As a result of the conflict, the now 23-year-old man was arrested and charged with assault.
It ain't funny, but
he was released from jail after posting bail. In the ensuing legal battle, the true identity of Phoenix Jones was revealed to the public, with many being shocked when they found out who he actually
y'all
was.
Y'all got guns in Canada? No, not at all. Absolutely not. Super safe country. Trudeau just banned assault rifles and all that, so we don't have that no more. Mm-mm, it's impossible. It's a myth. I was just talking. I just yapping.
Phoenix Jones, self-styled superhero and self-proclaimed defender of Seattle. The comic book vigilante who has ended up on the wrong side of the law after being accused of assault dramatically unmasked himself outside one of the city's courts on Thursday, revealing the man behind the mask, Benjamin Foder.
I'm Phoenix Jones. I'm also Ben Foder. I also protect the city. I also am a father. I also am a brother.
It was also soon reported that he would unfortunately lose his job as a teacher. While some believe that this was unjustified, it was perhaps inevitable.
I don't know if it's justifiable, but I also don't know if you feel me, like that you would have to actually do some thinking about that, and I'm not willing to do that right now. Canada smells like curry, just racist, bro. Come on.
Meant that this all was for the best. If he was consistently involving himself in danger, he could also inadvertently lead danger to the children that he was trying to teach. You know, he'd piss off a villain.
That dude was allowed to work with kids.
And they come for your class. This
I guess so, bro.
Was a good indication
I guess so.
Of what was to come.
You know, because he had his identity hidden, maybe the school board didn't even know it was him.
Time stopper. But this Smart. Only being the start of his many controversies. One thing that's important to note is that throughout his entire career, Jones had been supported by his romantic partner, Purple Rain. She was another hero who was a member of the Rain City superhero
group. Yeah, man. A girl will get you doing some crazy stuff, bro. A girl will really get you doing some crazy, crazy stuff you would have never thought about doing. This is just a proof.
Movement. Her primary goal was to promote awareness surrounding domestic abuse, as she was a victim of it herself, even running her own nonprofit organization that helped spread the message of this further. However, things in their relationship didn't seem to be going well, as she would post a message to Facebook on November 13th of 2013, claiming that the two had separated. I think it's time to make a public statement announcing that Phoenix Jones and I are no longer together.
Bro, nobody gives, who cares?
I will not be working together with him on any future projects. I have always conducted myself in a professional and respectable manner and do not wish to share the details of our separation. I wish Phoenix and the RCSM the best of luck in their future endeavors. This would not be the end of Phoenix's struggle to maintain positive relations with his peers. In 2014, it was reported by news outlets.
Yo, since there's so many like superhero groups, imagine if I created a super villain group and we fought against each other on like a nightly basis. Oh, how sick would that be, bro? Oh my gosh. I'd be like their arch nemesis. Wow. Good idea, Chad, or no?
That the Rain City superhero movement, the group that Phoenix had been the leader of and spearheaded for years, was officially breaking up. Jones himself accused many of the heroes under him of not following proper procedure, claiming that many of them even carried illegal weaponry. Something that was obviously a problem for a group of individuals trying to operate within the confines of the law. However, former members
at that point,
such
just break the law.
Shockwave and El Caballero accused Jones.
No comment. Come on, 30, join me.
Being a generally
join me, 30,
who had mishandled his role in the group, indicating that there were some other serious problems going on behind the
they
scenes.
They thought they looked so cool. They thought they looked so cold in this picture. They thought they looked so cold in this picture, like they were the next group. Yeah, take a pic. Yeah, this is going to go crazy on Facebook. Yeah, take a pic. Take a picture. Yeah. We the next Justice League. Take a picture.
Though these situations certainly didn't help, this would be far from the event that truly destroyed his reputation, at least in scale.
We could have been heroes. We could have been something.
Not being very superhero.
We could have been something.
He regained quite a bit of recognition after reigniting his passion for martial arts in 2015. Officially signing on the World Series of Fighting and performing under a superhero name, as opposed to Benjamin Fodor. Despite this, the fanfare surrounding his initial burst onto the scene had greatly died down. And outside of a few miscellaneous articles and reports documenting him,
yo, the nigga just beating his ass.
Phoenix was talked about much less. It wouldn't truly be until 2019. Until it was officially confirmed by Benjamin during an interview with the NW Nerd podcast that he was retiring Phoenix Jones for good. When asked about his reasoning for doing so, he would state, quote, "In the end, there's not a balance. It doesn't make sense. I've seen
now you know it doesn't make sense.
I've seen what people do to each other, and I live with it every day. Every day, I live with horrible, horrible things. And I think to myself, I've made a difference, but I didn't make a difference."
Infiltrate the enemy, moving on them randomly. Feels like the life I need's a little distant, yeah.